And this, if the West Indies to win, one would think would be a match-winning partnership. Lara and Hooper. Four runs outside half of the bat, but a boundary. So it's going to be a great morning's cricket here at Kensington. 100 up for the West Indies, the first of little milestones. They need 308 for victory. Move to 101. Brilliant. Brilliant.
That is an absolutely superb shot. Too much whip there for McGrath. With a swinging ball, this is a fair shot. Does leave him and head right out of the delivery and just smashes that right through the vacant cover region. Beautiful shot, straight along the ground. Obviously one of the shots of the morning, probably one of the shots of the matches in the situation.
He waited for the shot and just controlled it around nice and easily. It wasn't a quick bouncer, got into position early and just waited.
Well, this time he's decided to play the hook shot. We saw him get out in the first innings to a bouncer. And this time he just got inside of it and hit it around. Didn't overhit it. Just made sure he got bat on ball. It was a very similar delivery to that one in that first innings.
Nice use of the feet. And he's got under that one and whipped it away over the middle of the ball.
Because the way he plays down the track and it's up and over. Extremely safe shot for the left hand of the ball spinning into him.
Close to run away again. Gone for another four. Was it close to the pitch of this one as he was to the one previously? But he got that onto it.
Almost identical shot. Again, good use of the feet and hitting with the spin. Very safe shot. Stephen Moore has now reacted to that.
Very delicately played. And away from the man, so three fours in the first over, and Lara's on. What a clever shot to finish off the over. Three fours and a two in the West Indies have shot up to 122 for five. And he's got that away, it's gone for four. Really a long hop, and Lara puts it away. So another boundary to Brian Lara. The West Indies move on to 133 for 5 as we see the pull shot. Long hop and he's put that over the ground. It's gone right on top of the Bernardine Haynes stand. Spotted that very, very quickly and raises his 50 with a maximum.
Well, what an unbelievable response from Brian Lara. This ball's gone miles. Hits the top of the roof.
That's well played too. That ball spun back in a long way. It'll go all the way to the boundary. Desperate run there to get there, but another boundary from Lara's got the power going.
This is brilliant batting for Brian Lara. He's responded to a little bit of aggression from the Australians. Just taken the bull by the horns and played his shots. And that is a beautiful late cut.
Magnificent cut shot. That is pure perfection. Right on top of it. Four on the wrist. Four more.
This is absolute class. Letting the ball come to him. There's a wrong one and the most exquisite of back cuts. That just raced away to the boundary.
Lovely shot. Right on top of it. No third round. And with this hard ball, it's raced away before.
He's in the most exquisite form, Brian Lara. slightly short leg. The ball did actually move back at Brian Lara, but just let the ball come to him. This is the secret of his batting. Let the ball come to him and then just guides it down through the slip area, and that's just raced away.
That's disdainful. Absolute disdain. Putting a long hop through it on.
Well, this is almost ridiculous. Brian Lara knows that Stephen Law has covered the option on the offside, so he decides, well, we haven't got anyone mid-on, that's where I'll hit it. This is just awesome stuff. And that's a pretty good prediction. I wonder if they've just written that out or they had it like that this morning. But we have game on. Fans know it.
And he's popped it on the helmet. Ducking. Which is what I'm sure a lot of people have advised him to do rather than trying to jump and play the ball down. A little bit of by play between between McGrath and Lara. The tension showing out in the middle as well. Adams goes down. The crowd loves it. This is what Test cricket international sporting contests are all about. And he's pulling away from the ball. Doesn't the crowd enjoy that? A rousing way to raise the 100 partnership. You could not want it better. As a battle, as a contest, here's the replay. West Indies up to 207 now for five.
Beautiful shot.
98 runs for that. Didn't quite smash to the middle, but he hit it well enough, and the placement was as usual perfect.
One of fuller length is from Jason Gillespie. Same sort of movement going across the body of Brian Lara, but a fuller length. Got to the pitch and spanked it through the offside. You don't need to move when you play shots like that.
That's four runs. Off the back foot, bang, the square on the offside. Glorious shot again from Lara.
Well, he just lifts himself up on his toes to get above this ball. Bang, punches it forward a point. No chance for the man there. A cover point. Straight over the top of that delivery. Absolute disdain there.
That's his 100. Brian Lara gets it over the top. And the West Indies captain, the prodigal son turned messiah, gets his second 100 in successive tests. And if the 213 at Sabina Park revived West Indies fortunes, this one here has transformed a match in which they seem to have absolutely no chance to get even where they are now.
Claps, applause from everyone at this ground. Standing ovation from the Australian crowd, West Indian crowd, everyone. Claps from the players. A very good innings at a final time. There's probably only a couple of men that could do this under this situation in the world. And unfortunately for the Australians, he's right here now and he's doing the business.
There's one. Reduces the deficit to 49.
That's a good shot. Brian Lara initially was looking to let the short balls go, ducking as much as possible.
Swept away another goal for four. Reece McGrath. 42 meter.
That's just showing you the class of this man, Brian Lara. Before this delivery was bowled, Steve Waugh stopped play and was very meticulous about placing Glenn McGrath at backward square. Paused, kept him going another 5 yards to his left, and Brian Lara hit it exactly where he was coming from.
before. Lara doesn't get the strike, but he gets four and reduces the winning target to 34. West Indies 274 free. Magnificent cover drive. Well, that is out of the very top draw.
Lots of men on the boundaries. All around the park to prevent this from happening, but what a shot. Just slightly over pitched outside the off stump. There's no one on that boundary.
No nails. Spectators everywhere on the edge of their seats and on the roofs. In the air, drops! Healy's dropped it into his left hand and out. Lara tried to glide it past first slip. Gillespie did the work and Healy let him down.
That is why we saw Shane Warne coming into that slip cordon. They know they have to get rid of Brian Lara. Very good delivery this from Gillespie. And Healy couldn't hang on.
The entire Caribbean will be willing the West Indies these runs. McGrath starts what may be an historical over.
They're in the air. So Lara's been dropped on two occasions. So did Shane Warne get a hand on it or not? Two runs, three to win.
I think this just evaded Shane Warne in the slip corner. Thickish edge. There he goes, but nowhere near it, Shane Warne, just evading him. But look at that. Michael Slater, the man down at third man. What a dive, preventing that ball from going into the boundary.
He can take the one to tie the game.
He snaps it away. He snaps it. Will he come back for two? No, he can't. Yes, he can. No, he won't. Scores are level. Scores are level here. And one ball left in the over because of the wide. Gillespie.
In test match history has just been witnessed here at the Kensington Oval. So Brian Lara, Sherwin Campbell with his century. So Brian Lara finished with 153, not out. They chased 308 for victory. He got booed onto the field 24 hours ago after sending in Pedro Collins as night watchman. And he goes from the field as a hero. Clive Lloyd embraces. So what will they do with Brian Lara here? This will take him a month to get off the ground. Michael Holley, one of the great test matches and one of the great test match chases on the last day.
Certainly is. 308 runs in the last innings. Not many people thought that the West Indies would get there, especially when they lost those five early wickets. 105 for five. And that man has done it. Right in the middle of that big crowd.